That's why I drive whenever possible. I got a 2006 Subaru Outback. Yeah, all right, man.
Been through a lot together. Been through a lot together with the Roo.
Had a recall on the Roo recently. Apparently, the passenger side airbag could blow up. Had to take her in for a recall. My Roo and I, we've been through a lot. Anyone with a vehicle, you go through a lot. Your vehicle becomes like family. You ever rub the dashboard? Going up a hill in really cold weather? I had my Subaru in -3 degrees. I'm like, you got this, girl. You got this. I feel like it matters. It's like rubbing a horse's neck. I go in for the recall. I've never done that before. I walk in, they go, no problem, sir. We'll take your car. It'll take about an hour and a half. You just sit tight, have some coffee, and we'll let you know when it's done. No sooner do I sit down, attractive lady who works for Subaru comes walking up with a clipboard. She goes, I just want you to know we did a quick evaluation of your vehicle, and this is what it's currently worth, you know, which is nothing and devastating to hear. Like, I didn't ask for this information. And she goes, if you want, we could take this and put it towards a new vehicle, and you could be driving out with one of these beauties in less than a half hour. Now, this is just all happening so fast, and it's so insensitive. It's my vehicle. I'm looking at it through the window with the dash and coming apart. I'm telling you, man, I'm only bringing it up because it's happening with cars. Before you know it, it's going to be happening with us as humans. Man, you're going to be in there getting a quadruple bypass. The nurse is going to come out, go up to your wife. Listen, before we cut this war horse open, I just want to let you know we got three men in their early 30s on the other side of the wall here dying to take you out for a steak dinner. I go Valvoline. That's my oil, people. I go to Valvoline. Valvoline, they bring the dipstick into the waiting room to show you that they filled up your oil. Oh, how nice is that? I'm literally on the phone with my wife. He comes walking in. I'm like, yeah, what are you saying? I'm like, oh, hold on, baby. He's showing me the dipstick. This is Mr. Correale. I just want to show you. Filled it all the way up right there. I'm like, beautiful, man. Thank you very much. Nothing about cars. But the guy can walk in and show me a completely dry going. I totally drained all the oil out of the car. It's bone dry. I go, beautiful, get that oil out of there. I was making an appointment with Valvoline recently. They had me on hold and I had it on speaker. And Take It to the Limit by the Eagles was playing. And my wife comes walking down the stairs, starts babbling right away, and I go, hold on, they're about to pick up. And she goes, oh my God, why do you think that? Because the song is ending? Which is really what I thought. We all do that. You ever on hold? And when your song ends, you do. You think they're gonna pick up? Which is bizarre. Because that means I think there's a guy in Valvoline hovering over the phone, listening to the Eagles song, going, one more.